Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can use file dialog in Python to open and read the contents of a file. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Okay, people, so this is how you can use file dialog to open and read the contents of a file. But first, we'll need a second import along with this import at the top. So what we're going to be importing is from tkinter import file dialog. And then we'll need a window like what we usually do. So window equals tk followed by window.mainloop. Now we'll need a button that we're going to add to the window, and when we click on this button, it's going to launch our file dialog so we can select a file. So we'll call this button button, button equals button. Let's set some text, maybe to just open, like we're opening a file, and we'll associate a function to our command for this button. So let's create a function called open file. That's fine. And then we need to pack this button so we can add it to the screen. So button.pack. Now we need to create a function called openFile, and we'll do this before we create our window. Let's type def openFile. And when we call this function, we're going to take file dialog and use the askOpenFileName function. So this is going to return a string, and that string is the file path of where your file is located. So what we could do is store this within a variable. So let's store this within a variable called file path. And to test this, let's just print this, just to take a look at the contents of this variable. So let's just print the file path. Now I have a file on my desktop that I want to use called test file. So let's click the open button. And this might not necessarily bring you to your desktop. It might bring you someplace else within your file directory. So this just happens to bring me to my desktop. So I'm going to click the test file that I have and click open. So this prints the file path. So it's going to return a string, and it's the file path basically. So now we want to open and read the contents of this file. So we don't really need this print line anymore. So what we'll do is create a file variable, and we're going to use open. We're going to list the file path, and then we're going to use r for read. So the default is normally rt for read text, otherwise you can read binary, but we can just set this to r. R is the same as rt basically. So then we're going to open this file, and then we're going to read it. So let's just print this to the console window. So print the name of the file, which is file, where this is located, file.read function. And then it's a good idea to close your files after you're done with them. So file.close. And let's test this. So I'm going to click open, find the file that I want, click it, and then open. And that text file says, my name is Bro, I like pizza. Now let's say you want to make this a little more advanced. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to set the initial directory of where we begin looking for a file when we launch our file dialog. So with that test file, I'm going to move this to my project folder. So I'm just going to paste it. So now this is within my project folder. Now I'm going to set the initial directory within the function of askOpenFileName. So we're going to set the initial dir for initial directory, and then we can list a file path. So one thing you could do, I want to get this path here, this file path. So if you're using PyCharm, what you could do is right click this, copy path, and then get the absolute path. And then I'm just going to paste this. And then with these backslashes, you'll have to do double backslashes because this is the escape character for a backslash. All right, so this should open my project folder, which it does. And here's that test file. Another thing we could do is that we can change the title of our file dialog. Right now the default is just open, so we can change that to something else. So I'm going to add a comma, maybe put this on a different line. So this is still within the function of askOpenFileName. So I'm going to set the title to something else. I'll say openFile. Okay. So if we were to run this again, instead of just saying open, it says openFile. Okay. And we can also limit the file types that we accept and look for. So we can use filetypes. So let's say that we want to initially look for a txt file. So what we'll do is type in like a name for the file that we're looking for. So this is what's going to appear to the user. Text files followed by an extension. So we want *.txt. And then we can also have an option for all files. So I'm going to add a comma for a second option. And then let's say all files and then an extension. So comma *.*. This will look for all files, but I think I am missing a parenthesis. There, that should be good. So then when we open our file dialog, it's going to initially be looking for plain text files. And with this drop-down menu, it says text files and all files. So that's what we have listed within our file types of what we want to search for. So you can see that if I switch to all files, our Python file actually appears because we don't have any limits on the files that we're trying to open or search for. So if I change this back to text files, only folders and plain text files are visible. So then we can open our test file again. But yeah, that's the basics of file dialog. In the next video, we're going to be saving a file. So if you'd like a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of opening a file using Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.